Kratos, tell me of an adversary from your homeland. It will serve us well if I understand more of your battle tactics.
There was Medusa, Queen of the Gorgons. Her gaze turned men to stone. A mirror would turn her own powers against her. Or, you may remove her head, but that is the hard way.
Which did you choose?
The hard way.
Forget I asked. Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that pass, which must mean...
Another Hapkufa!
Odd. It looks as though the Light Elves sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My. That is lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
I remember when Freyr and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hapkufa. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave!
Said. The Aesir burned him.
Yes. We weren't yet at war, but relations with the Vanir and Aesir had been hostile for ages. Freyr got it into his head that he could improve relations by sharing our magic with them. Vanir techniques for bountiful harvests, enough to feed their whole population. Getting set on fire was the thanks he got.
That's true. The Aesir were too undisciplined and impatient for the subtlety of Vanir spellcraft. So, when things went wrong, blamed their teacher.
So Freyr was a guest when Odin burned him?
Not exactly. Odin didn't mind locking Freyr up. He saw the potential of the magic and wanted to know more than how to improve crop yields.
Another time. We must focus.
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hapkufa is free. This architecture... it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
reach it from down here. This kind of hive material is sensitive to sound. How odd. When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by this matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped half-elf for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Maybe the Twilight Stone on the ground will help. Well, there you go.
Enemy behind you, Kratos!
Cover! We bastards are about to explode!
Enemies on the left!
Behind you! Look out!
Red Elves don't often travel underneath the Barrens, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Helheim. Also to peers.
Big Deer did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corps below would disagree. Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
Go!
nasty hit! You all right, brother?
Dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate. I wonder if these two comprehend the choice that these things make.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hakufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Well, given another chance, I know what choice I would make. Well done. Time to set it loose.
Aye. Back to the surface, then.
Look out! Copperpipe.
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame
Kratos,
of...
is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. She died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well... at least it's a relatable story.
Years we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim. Yet again.
Solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know. There is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they. Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
Said Frey was not exactly a guest of the Aesir.
I meant by the time they burned it, he'd been a prisoner for some time. It was a mob of lesser Aesir, bitter and short-sighted, who tied him up and lit him aflame as punishment for the sabotage they imagined him guilty of.
Not now. Jewelry.
Oh? Put it on one of my horns. Let's see if I can pull it off.
No.
An elven library?
An archive of knowledge.
No sign of the Light Elves.
For now.
Maybe they've left for the day, and we can browse at our leisure.
Here.
So, these are the Valine schematics, eh?
You know of him?
Aye. One of the most gifted dwarven smiths around. Until he developed a conscience, anyhow.
These texts alone are not enough to end the Elven War, but restricting their access only serves those who wish to prolong it.
Taking a page out of Odin's book.
Aye. Quite the advantage for the Light Elves.
Sealed, but there is an inscription. The consul.
Bigvir spoke of an exile of the same name. Odds are he'd like a gander at that particular text. Ah, it appears the librarian would like a word.
Lata Framborg.
Sounds like she wants that journal back.
No.
Use a shield strike!
Here.
a shield strike!
Come on, Kratos, off your back!
Protecting them by hiding all this knowledge away.
Our ally wishes to read this journal. We are taking the book.
I'm impressed. Thought you were going to end her.
When last we traveled here, after Fey passed, I killed an elf of great importance. The ramifications were dire for his people. I do not wish to make the same mistake twice. Being burned by the Aesir mob.
Well,
enough. We will continue later.
Rot!
What's your life?
Oh!
The beauty of a locked door. It could be anything. Monsters, treasure. Knowing our luck, it'll be a bit of both.
Oh! sight! Ugh!
Freya, you once revived a giant's corpse to stop a certain fight we won't talk about. Could you call on that power again?
Maybe. Do you have a massive giant's corpse for me to revive?
No.
Well, there you go.
So you just refuse to pick a favorite poem? That's uncharacteristically indecisive of you.
I have a favorite poem already. One from my homeland. What is that?
A phantom! Rune magic! Aim for the runic core!
Bloody hell! Look at that thing!
It's vulnerable when it glows!
Nicely done! Keep on it! Leave yourself an opening! Don't waste it!
Switching arrows!
Look at that thing!
recovers!
Take out those things, brother! Brother! winter, I suppose.
The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
I was curious about some of the flora we've encountered on our travels.
And you will remain curious. It's not my job to teach you everything, Mimir.
Look, I was just asking.
And you have been told.
Say that again.
Tell of Freya being burned by the Aesir mob.
Well, I'll be Obviously, he survived. In fact, he used the opportunity to escape. But such an affront made war inevitable.
Freyr certainly wasn't the same after that. At least for a while. His carefree ways were replaced with nightmares, paranoia, and lashing out. It doesn't excuse what he said at my wedding, but I do understand where his anger came from. A statue of my brother. How quaint.
Survived Freya's absence, but a truce clearly did not. Monuments are useless to those who ignore their message.
He didn't create a truce through diplomacy alone. His godhood, his very presence is what healed this land and allowed peace to take root. But once he left, he had to have known what he was.
Well, he had good reason to leave. Some jackass convinced his sister to marry a madman.
Crystals contain their own life.
You're right. Normally we'd have to provide our own. Perhaps slotting a crystal on the opposite side could shed some light on this mystery. Another raven sent to the Tree of the Dead. Perhaps we should check up on it, hmm?
Monuments are useless. Why restore this one?
It was hidden for some time. Perhaps now it can serve as a reminder.
Aye. Nothing reminds people of their history like chiseled, well-lit marble. We can read the inscription now as well.
Light from the crystals. It is in the sand now.
Would you look at that? Freyr's gift endures after all. Or should I say... presence.
You are not funny.
Even when Freyr was actually here, the peace was fragile. Surely a bit of extra light in the desert isn't enough to make it last.
Before I met Fae, I could not imagine a life of peace. After her death, in our travels to Jotunheim, I found peace on my own. It remains my responsibility to make it last.
Perhaps the elves will find peace again one day, even without Freya's guidance.
His presence continues to guide them, whether they realize it or not.
Perhaps we can bring these two animals back to Vanaheim, or Midgard even. Speki and Spanna could use the company. We have Fennel.
It would not go well for them. Once a predator becomes accustomed to a land, it is cruel to move them.
I suppose you're right. It just seems lonely out here.
It is peaceful. They have each other. It is enough.
A dawn bloom. You have an interest in botanicals now?
Another sleeping troll, courtesy of the dwarves. Come on, brother. Let's have it. You mentioned you had a favorite poem from your homeland. What was it about?
A cunning general. A war over forbidden love.
I believe I've heard of this one. Did it involve a horse that was not as it appeared?
Yes. But that is not what happened.
Oh, it's based on truth then. You were there.
Yes. I prefer the poem.
Yeah. say, I think we make a good team. With my brains, Bakos' brawn, and my lady's,
wisdom? Magic? Ability to tolerate you for long periods of time?
I was going to say brutality.
That works.
Freya, I've always wondered, why was Freya so revered here so quickly upon his first...
Out of!
Take it off, man! You've got this!
Behind you! Look out!
This is a fine mess!
My travels, I heard of a great battle in your homeland, at a place called the Gates of Fire.
gates.
You were there?
No.
Is that regret in your voice?
I did regret not dying there for many years. But no longer.
Earlier you mentioned that Freyr was one of Alfheim's first visitors. Care to elaborate? I wasn't in these lands at the dawn of realm travel.
Well, we believed for a long time that all the giants had died in the Flood, until one of them appeared in Vanaheim. Her name was Gerd, and she came offering to teach us the secrets of traveling between realms using Bifrost. Freyr became immediately infatuated with her. He always yearned to wander, and along came someone who could truly show him how. So, wander they did, exploring the world tree from root to branch. But one day, it came time for Gerd to wander away. Freyr was heartbroken, and resolved himself to perform some great feat to win her back.
Old. We will finish later.
Something is coming, and it's not happy.
and it's not happy. Not happy. It's not happy. Not happy. Something is coming, and it's not happy. Something is coming, and it's not happy. Not happy. It's not happy.
Here it comes!
It's not happy. Not happy. It's not happy. And it's not happy.
Afraid!
It's not happy. It's not happy. It's not happy.
Oh,
on, brother.
Not happy. It's not happy.
Guess is as good as mine. Imprisoning a Drake. Can't decide whether to be impressed or horrified.
Either way, it is over now.
There. Getting back to your brother. What did he do to win back Dove? And how did it end up with him being worshipped?
Well, Freyr thought big. He set his aim on the grandest of gestures. He intended to be the first to find the elusive source of Bifrost Light. And he succeeded, although quite by accident. Freyr believed he navigated best while fortified by a potent blend of Vanir herbs. When he wandered, he wandered. And he managed to wander from the World Tree directly into the Lake of Souls.
Let this wait. Stay
alert. We'll just stop there for now. Before you see the lad again, might we discuss an approach?
He will tell me where he has been. That is my approach.
Ah, classic Spartan diplomacy.
Wait. Did you say Odin invited him to Asgard, and then he disappeared for 2 days?
Aye. But surely the lad's got more sense than to...
Don't underestimate Odin's powers of persuasion. He filled my son's head with lies. Why wouldn't he do the same with yours?
Sucker, he owes me one.
Thank me now and eternally.
Well, looky there. Glad you can make the trip, your goddessness. I put your sigil magic on the young turd's bow. But then he and Sindri got into it over something.
That dress.
Well, come on then. Hey, Tyr! Wake up! You got company. Now, why don't you just make yourself at home in Sindri's sofa?
You better screw his head back on, and I mean tightly.
So you're back.
Are you ready to answer me?
About what?
Where did you go? What did you see? Was it Odin?
What? Is that what you think?
Do you deny it? Answer me! Did you go to Asgard?
No! Of course not! But so what if I did? It's my future, it's my life.
You are my son.
Then why don't you trust me?
If you want me to trust you, then tell me the truth.
The truth is you're being a complete asshole.
Laddie, you know that's no way to change a man's mind.
He doesn't have any faith in me. It's fine if he keeps secrets. It's fine if Mom did.
It is not fine. Her secrets haunt every step of this path.
Oh, okay. So you don't believe in her anymore either?
This is not about your mother. What you have done is lie.
Wonder where I learned that.
That's quite enough.
Since when do you always take his side?
Since he became the one making sense.
Look, I was only thinking about going to Odin, but I swear it's for a good reason.
There is no good reason to go to Odin.
He'll only cloud your mind.
But I'd be going for us. I gotta stop something bad from happening.
Something bad did happen. Look at me, at Freya, at Tyr. Odin did this to us.
What's got everyone caterwauling all of a sudden?
Atreus wants to go to Asgard.
Asgard? Get kicked in the head or something?
Great. I guess everybody's against me now.
You must choose who you are going to be. Are you going to continue to lie and keep things from me? Or are you my son?
Choose? I never get to choose. Just leave me alone.
Listen.
Let go of me!
Listen!
Let go!
What the fuck?
Atreus! It's Sindri. Just try to keep control!
Come on! Come on!
and trolls, lots of hellwalkers, definitely in Midgard. Erbahuta! These things! When did it get so bad out here? Keep it coming. You're just helping me stay warm. Yep. Home, sweet home. Gotta find some shelter. At least something out here doesn't want to kill me.
Just need someplace warm.
Then I can figure out where to go next. That doesn't look good. What is this thing? Some kind of white? What is it you want? Jump up! Trying to tell me something? First, he thinks I've been to Asgard. Then, blind. I'm trying to save your life, you big jerk!
Yeah!
And then what? Where could I go? If I go to Asgard, following the prophecy where Father ends up dead, if I stay locked up at home, there's nothing I can do to stop it. I guess in Asgard, I could at least keep an eye on Odin. Be a spy. Find out his plan. Take control of this. Oh, who am I kidding? I can't go to Asgard. Wait. Are those red leaves? Freya's house! Oh, no. Charlie! Oh, no. Charlie! Please. Please! Charlie! Stand to let me into that house. Think you can do that? Come on, Charlie. You have to do this. I can't help if you don't. Emily! Emily! Close that window if we're snooping around. Freya hasn't been checking on you? Right. Too busy hunting us down. Come on. Let's get you warmed up. Should be able to make a fire from all this mess. Is this Baldur's? I wonder how Father was able to earn her forgiveness. Valkyrie armor? Does this go with the wings on the wall? From her friend? Wonder what happened to her. Wow, it's beautiful. Never seen anything like this around here before. From her home in Vanaheim? She must have really missed it. I can't believe she never came back to check on her house. To check on you. That's not an excuse. Now. I can't stay. I just can't let my dad die, too. There's gotta be something I can do. He's here for me. I'll be okay. I think. Okay. I'm ready. Take me to him. Should have learned to swim before Midgard froze over. Hello? Oh, I'm here! Odin? Bert, is this Asgard? Hey, wait up! The wall! This is Asgard! Hold on! I'm coming! No! You don't seem friendly. Sign of Fimbulwinter. You could have led me around those. Yeah, danger. I know. Got it. I see him. Jump up! I gonna say to Odin? Hi. I came to be your apprentice, I guess? But it doesn't mean I, like, serve you now. Not in a Ford tour by from the other side of that wall. Wait, how do I get past the wall? It never came up in Mimir's story about Hrimthur. The stonemason's son built a flaw into it. He only told Frey about it, and I didn't think to ask. Hold on, where was Freya at the house? Did she move in with us? You know what? Focus, Loki. Yappa! Father would just burn this away with his blades. But what can I do? Ah! Huh. There we go. Wait. That sounds like people.
Help? You, look a little lost.
Oh. I'm just getting my bangs.
Well, there's nothing to see this way except the big wall.
Is there a gate to go through?
Nope. Not unless you're an Aesir god, but I guess you'd know that if you were an Aesir god.
Me? No. I'm from Midgard.
What? No shit. Me too. I'm Skildir.
Lucky. Hang on. Are you all from Midgard?
Yep. The, Allfather saved us from the desolation. Gave us a safe place to settle, but we don't go in there. Can't get into the city unless you know magic. You don't know magic, do you?
A little bit, yeah.
What? No shit. Can you walk through walls?
Not yet.
Huh.
Couldn't I just climb over it?
That? Without any gear? No. Aren't you afraid of dying?
Well, yeah. I mean, look at that. But Odin awaits.
Wait, you know the Allfather?
I'm sort of his apprentice.
No shit! What is he teaching you?
I'm not sure.
How many other students?
I don't know.
How long you stay? You don't know. Okay.
I'm gonna go climb that wall now.
Well, this I gotta see. Need help?
Appreciate it, but I gotta go alone.
Oh, I wasn't gonna climb with you. I may owe Odin my life, but I don't owe him my death. Not that I think you're gonna fall. Forget I said anything. Is that Hugin? Is Hugin your guide?
Who?
Odin's raven. You know, from Hugin and Munin. guy. Though, not sure he'll know too much about climbing. Well, Loki, you seem like a good guy. I really hope I am not about to watch you die.
Thanks. Me too.
You know not to look down, right?
I like looking down. Shows me how much progress I've made.
Wow. Yeah, that's great. Can I use that? I mean, a little ironic, his last words, but...
What was that?
Nothing. Nothing. Hey, you're doing great! You can do it, Loki!
Thanks, Gilder. Hope you're right. Okay, I can do this. This is fine. Just keep climbing. And now where? Hey, Hugin. Don't suppose you'd like to pass the time by telling a story, would ya? Yeah. That's what I thought you'd say. Right? Up here? Mouth up! I'm coming. Let's get that chain down. Yo. I wonder why I can't hear your thoughts. Sure seemed like Odin could. That was you in our cabin, right? You and your brother, I guess? Taking that for a yes. Breathe. And... yes! I bet I'm past the worst of it now. Or not. Wanna just let me pass through? No? Have it your way. Jump up! Help go! Yeah. Up. I get it. Whoa. Okay. Interconnected. Yeah. That made sense. I think. Gotta do both sides, though. Get to fly. I'm doing what I can. Huh. Don't see any more shortcuts. Just gotta climb a little further. Maybe a lot further. But I've come this far. Hey, Hugin. How about I tell you a story? Once there was a giant named Loki, who thought it'd be a good idea to accept Odin's invitation to Asgard. So, Odin tested Loki, expecting him to climb, by himself, all the way up Hrimthor's wall. So, what did Loki... Ah! So what did Loki do? He kept climbing. He just kept climbing. His arms hurt. His fingers went numb. It got hard to breathe. But Loki kept climbing. One foothold at a time. All the way to the top. Nowhere to go but up. Okay, okay, keep going. Come on, can't stop now. Ah! Come on. Okay. I can do this. I can do this. Almost there.
Hello.
Hi.
So, what part of the enormous wall made you think, oh, visitors must be welcome?
I was sent for, actually, by Odin.
The Allfather sent for you. Great. Then why are you up there and not in here?
Why don't we ask him together?
Are you finished? Now, what could Odin, Allfather, King of the Aesir, possibly want with the likes of you?
That's between me and Odin.
You don't even know, do you?
Think you could pull me up, or...
No, I don't think I will.
I think maybe I'll drop you.
No.
Yes, I'm going to drop you. Goodbye.
Think how mad the Allfather's gonna be when he finds out you killed his guest. Loki of the Jotnar?
The Jotnar. Enemy of my people.
I am not your enemy.
I will be the judge of that. This way, Loki of the Jotnar.
Wait, is that Gjallarhorn? Are you Heimdall?
Obviously. Now feel free to drink in the splendor of Asgard. This is a rare sight for outsiders. Especially giants. Yes. Why not steal anything that is not nailed down? That is sure to impress your hosts. Just ask your questions already.
How do you know I had questions?
It is my job. Next question.
What is your job?
I protect the realm I love from trouble.
And you think I'm trouble? You just met me.
And I can already see you are eager to prove yourself. Way too eager. Probably due to an overshadowing father figure you can never live up to.
Good guess.
I would also guess that you are disrespectful, entitled, and impulsive.
You don't know me at all. I help people.
Oh! You are here to help people. No. You are here to help yourself. To manipulate and lie to whoever you have to get what you want. I know you're young. Your voice probably dropped while you were climbing the wall, but... what a twisted little soul you have. You are chaos in a spiffy archer suit. I watch your mouth move and I see cities burning. Nothing good is going to come from you leaving Asgard. That said, if you are here to aid the Allfather and have no treacherous intent, I guess that makes us allies. Gulltorper, who loves me the most? Who loves me the most?
Wow, that's almost as impressive as Baldur taming a dragon.
Baldur had the luxury of not caring how badly he got burned. I outthink them. Dominate them fair and square.
Whoa, are these all Aesir gods?
What? You think all Aesir are gods?
But Skildur told me that only...
Oh, well, if Skildur told you... Clearly, whoever that is must be the authority on Aesir gods, not the Aesir god you are currently talking to. You literally know nothing of our culture, do you?
I know lots of things. I know a giant built that wall.
A giant built the wall that keeps out the giants.
Hrimthir, son of Thamur. I know the whole story.
Really? I truly cannot wait for you to regale me with the revisionist tales of Asgard's architectural history.
Is that Odin's palace?
Palace? Do you think the Allfather needs to puff himself up like some mortal chieftain?
I guess not.
That is the Great Lodge, which the Allfather built with his own hands. I'm sorry if that is a letdown for you. Real power, you see, does not need to flaunt. It emerges when the time is right. Don't you agree?
Ah! Hey! Whoa! Ah!
Hey! Helmets! I brought you a practice dummy.
I thought we were going to Odin!
You see, the thing is, you need to represent it. So, I am not letting you anywhere near the Allfather.
That is your big special move. Now, boy.
That's right. Show me all of your stupid little tricks.
Oh, very nice.
It is a wonder that the Jotnard lost every war they ever fought.
Well, that was boring. Guess who's next?
You sure you want to keep our father waiting?
Funny thing, I am sure of that. Yes, I'm feeling very sure of that, in fact.
Whoa! Whoa! How is he doing?
Oh! Not even close! That's all you got? How have you survived this long?
Oh no! Arrows! How fearsome!
You're not gonna stop me from seeing Odin!
You'll be seeing him from your grave.
What? That doesn't even make sense!
Oh!
That one felt special!
Hope that was not the last trick you have! Is that it? Is this all you have to show me, Odin?
Wow. I do have to say, Loki, I am profoundly unimpressed. You should probably stay down. Great.
Like it or not, he's Allfather's guest.
I thought I smelled something.
Take one more step, you're not gonna like how this ends.
Really? And how do you intend to stop me?
Look into my eyes. You tell me.
You are a sick man.
Loki! You made it! I am so honored. I see you've met Heimdall. He reads minds for me.
The boy is false, Allfather.
This young man, who is my guest, is covered in mud. Care to explain?
He means to betray you.
Is that true, Loki? You a little trickster? I'm just messing around. Of course he means to betray me, Heimdall. Why else would he come? I've given him no reason to trust me. Not yet. But he's got some very big questions. And I have so many answers to give. What are you up to? Dismissed. Go.
Gladly.
And you, clean yourself up. Heimdall, will you just relax? Were you intending on killing me first thing? See? What, that's not good enough for you? Get out of here! He's a lot, I know. Very perceptive, but sometimes he just forgets to think. You know? Hey, I got some places to be. So how'd your father take the news that you decided to accept my invitation?
I don't think we should talk about my father.
That well, huh? Can't blame him. Between my ex-wife and my disgruntled former employee, he's not exactly getting an unbiased view. But you, you're curious, open-minded. That's important. Reist, Meist, carry on. Pretend I'm not here. If I'm being honest with you, Loki, you're lucky my offer still stands after you went and sprung Tyr. But I suppose spending time with him is punishment enough, isn't it? At least Mimir never lost his sense of humor. But look, that's all behind us now. I like to keep looking forward.
Hey! I want them trained, not decapitated. Just keep it below the neck, all right? Is that really what you do when I'm not here?
Allfather.
Queen Gna.
The Ainhur-Yar are ready for your blessings.
That's why I'm here, isn't it?
Yes, there's a new Valkyrie Queen.
Great soldiers, these Ainhur-Yar. They tend to come out of Valhalla a little foggy. I do what I can for them, help them remember who they were in life. That's important, don't you think? A sense of identity gives things meaning. Moon Thi Nafin, Hrothgar. Moon Thi Nafin, Gorm. Moon Thi Nafin, Tiana. Okay, next up. Ah, the books. Good. Those are for him. I understand you're an avid reader. These are just a few things from my personal collection.
Thanks.
Jurgen, those better not be mushrooms I smell.
Listen, I appreciate your offer, but I'm really not sure what you're expecting from me.
Right now, you're just visiting, Loki. One step at a time. Steady there, Carl.
But with all respect, you need to know. I came to study, not to serve.
Another servant is the last thing I need. I need someone with drive, with curiosity. Someone will take initiative. That looks good. Is that braised?
But why me? Is it because I'm half giant?
Big deal. So's Thor. Erlen, try to stay awake for me.
Okay. But...
Look, don't overthink it. I have a project I think you'll be interested in. A major learning opportunity for both of us.
What about my family? My friends? I need to know nobody's gonna get hurt.
Why would I hurt anybody? A truce is all I've been asking for from the start, if you recall. Look, you're here now. Stop worrying. It's all gonna be fine. Almost to your room.
My room?
Yep, just over here. Feel free to come and go. Take what you need, poke around as you please. You're not my prisoner. And more importantly, I'm not your father.
Allfather, there's a situation that needs your attention.
Sif, you missed welcoming our new house guest. Say hello to Loki.
This is him? Here. In our home. How nice.
My diplomat. Everything all right in New Midgard?
The refugees are fine. The situation is with the dwarves. You know who is back.
Yeah, it's always something. Put those books down. We got another stop to make.
Sure.
I'm here. Where is he?
Just over there, Allfather. Sir?
Chief? It's been too long. What's the issue now?
No issue at all if you're trying to build volatile death traps.
I approve these designs personally, and not all that recently, I might add. Did you just wake up with the urge to be a pain in my ass?
Yeah. Who's the cut? You draining pickpockets?
You know what, Durlan? You reek of cheap mead, and that is by far your most endearing characteristic. Now listen up. It's me, your entire economy, speaking. I want you to know that I have confidence in you. Confidence you can deliver me these machines as promised, on time, on budget, and, of course, safely. The dwarves have never let me down, and they're not about to start now. Right? Good. Okay, so I'm gonna let you catch your breath. When you're ready to get to work and start getting those answers, meet me in my study down the hall. Oh, and help yourself to a change of clothes.
Guess I could try this on. Has less mud on it, anyway. Whoa, I can use this. Nicely equipped. What needs work?